Yes, dear students, you can see here on the blackboard English grammar for all the sections of class 12. This is once again you will see syntax here in your grammar. The pronoun. So I have taught you in my previous videos rules of article, rules of noun, and in noun I have taught you rules of numbers, single number and plural number, and rules of possessive case. So today, before going to start your rules of pronoun, I would like to give you just introduction of the kinds of pronoun, because this is equally important for you to understand your different kinds of pronoun. If you do not have just idea about these kinds of pronoun, you cannot use it in your grammatical way. You cannot avoid mistakes in your sentence. So you must have to understand very well the all kinds of pronoun. Here you can see first personal pronoun. Personal pronoun. In Hindi, you can say nisvachak sandhya, vyaktivachak, sorry, vyaktivachak, sarvanam. Once again, see, personal pronoun, vyaktivachak, sarvanam. That is what personal pronoun. So, in your personal pronoun, you will study person, you will study person. There are three persons. What are they? First person, second person, and third person. So you can see here, first person, second person, and third person. Okay? In your first person, you will find I, we. In our nominative case, me, us. In our objective case, my, mine, our, ours. In your possessive case, so there are three cases: nominative, objective, and possessive case. So on the basis of all these three cases, you will have to define yourself here in first person, nominative case, we, I and we, I in your singular, we in your plural. Just similarly, you will find in your objective case, we, me and us. Me and us in our objective case, singular and plural, my, mine, our, ours in our possessive case. So these are called first person. These are your first person. Now in second person, you will find yours. You means what? In your nominative case, second person, nominative case, again you, objective case, and yours in your possessive case. thou, thy, thine. Thy, thou, thy, thine. These are also used, but in olden days. But nowadays you will find only you. So these are called second person pronouns. And now see third person pronoun. In your third person pronoun, you will find he, she, it. In your nominative case, him, her, it. You will find also they. He, she, it, and they. All these are in your nominative case. Him, her, it, them. In your objective case, his, her, hers, its, their, theirs. In your possessive case, you will find all these in your possessive case. So whatever you have seen on the blackboard here, first person, second person, and third person. So all these you will find in nominative, objective, and possessive case. So these are helpful to you in the way of making English language. So this is your personal pronoun. On the basis of person, you have read your personal pronoun. Now you can see second reflexive pronoun. What is reflexive pronoun? Here, nishvachak. In Hindi, nishvachak sarvanam. Reflexive means nishvachak sarvanam. So, what will you find in your nishvachak sarvanam or in reflexive pronoun? Self are selves. Words, selves are selves added in a pronoun to make it reflexive pronoun. Just you can see self are selves added here in the way of just for I, myself, for we, ourselves. In plural you will use ourselves. Yes, E-M-E-E-S. You, yourself, as well as yourselves. In the third way, he, himself, she, herself, it, itself, they, themselves. So all these pronouns are used in our reflexive pronoun. Certainly, when we use in our language, when we use in a sentence, we will have to identify just how we use myself, ourselves, herself, himself, themselves. There is little difference between reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. In emphatic pronoun, you will again find self or selves. In reflexive pronoun, in emphatic pronoun, you will say in Hindi, drita suchak. So you can define it on the basis of your example. So how you will define it? Just what is difference between reflexive and emphatic pronoun? You can see on the blackboard here. See, hand herself. So whatever you have written here, just in the end of the sentence, that is just after the word, whatever you have written here, that is called reflexive pronoun. But she herself did it. Now little difference here. Here herself, once again you will find the herself, word herself. But there is little difference. Herself is used just before any pronoun like she. But here you will find just after any verb herself. So there is little difference between both reflexive and emphatic pronoun. So this is emphatic pronoun and this one is called reflexive pronoun. I think you have understood very well the same here. Number 4, demonstrative pronoun. In a demonstrative pronoun, you will find words this, that, these, those. All these 4 words are used here, demonstrative pronoun. This, that, these, those. So, for the singular number nearest, you will use this. For the singular number, for distant places, you will use that. This is my book, that is your bag. So if the things, anything that is in a very distant place, you will use that. That is your book, this is my book. This is difference. Similarly, these are my pens, those are your pens. So these are the difference between here, this, these, those, that, those. Here this is demonstrative pronoun. Now similarly you will find distributive pronoun. Distributive, each, either, neither, none, any. All these are just used to this distributive pronoun. You will see interrogative pronoun here. In interrogative pronoun, you will find just question words. You can say, what is your name? What? Where? Which? All these are called interrogative pronoun. But just after the end of a sentence, you will find question mark. What is your name? Where do you live? Which is your book? So all these question words are used here in your interrogative pronoun. Now see, relative pronoun. All these words are used in relative pronoun also. But in relative pronoun, you will use just that, what, where, which, anything. But you do not use any question mark. Here, just for example, I do not know where he lived. I do not know what your name is. So these are the relative pronouns. These are called relative pronouns. Just you will see reciprocal pronoun. In your reciprocal pronoun, you will find each other and one another. Each other and one another. So in your reciprocal pronoun, they love each other. So that is just for each other. Means if there is two persons, just for showing relation for both of them, so you will use each other. But more than two, you will use one another. The boys are playing in the field one another. The boys are playing one another. So thus, in the same way, we will use reciprocal pronoun. Now, see your next, indefinite pronoun. That is indefinite, each, any. Means all these words are used here in your indefinite pronoun. That is not definite, indefinite. Each of the boys can go to play. So each of the boys. यहाँ पर each means what? That is just indefinite. But is not definite. Any means any. So in this way you will use your pronoun. One more you can use here, exclamatory pronoun. What? He is dead. Such a type of words are used in exclamatory pronoun, but only 9 kinds of pronoun here in your course. You can see the same.